It is clear that your world has entered a stage where the old is departing, and the demand for true change by so many will be a massive force to bring the changes we and you have wished to see come forth. We are as busy as ever, monitoring developments and waiting eagerly for the next big event that will signal disclosure and the enactment of the new world financial system. Control of your financial system is how the dark on your world were able to gain power and influence, which is why it is so important to shift the wealth and the belief that is economy back into the hands of the people who truly deserve it and who can collectively run it quite peacefully. Abundance is to be granted to all, as you have all deserved abundance throughout your experiences, but your karma has served to keep you in a certain state, a certain condition, which the dark on your world serves to take advantage of by pumping out influences that support lower patterns and ways of living. The propaganda that has been run by your dark extends out much further than many of you realize. It will be a difficult truth for you to learn that nearly everything that has to do with your media exists only to keep the majority of humanity in the lower vibrations through subtle and gradual conditioning of mind. You see, once they have you out of your heart spaces where you are then vulnerable, they begin to work on conditioning the mind in ways that serve and fit only them. This is brought about very gradually, as mentioned above, and their methods of control have spanned generations of your history. In your era, the 1950s, they did maintain a pretty sturdy grip on the hearts and minds of so many souls. But as the new dawn approached towards the end of your 1960s, the elite realized they would have to become much trickier to trap so many of you back into the lower vibrations that they had worked so hard to keep you in for so long. In the 1970s of your history, they used many of the substances that served to awaken the hippie generation as tools of conditioning. They gained control of the illegal drug industry, and went very far out of their way to make sure that the marijuana so many were smoking back then was void of the light that is gifted into all healthily grown herbs of your dear Gaia. Many substances such as cannabis were and still are meant to be an aid for humanity, and in fact even in the 70s there were still souls who were growing very pure herbs that served to help one awaken to themselves, rather than to stimulate simple party amusements. The cannabis that was pretty much manufactured by the elite who gained control of these illegal industries only served to dull one's mind and stimulate amusements, rather than perform the original sacred purpose the cannabis and many other plants and herbs were meant for. Today, much of the cannabis that many in America are indulging in is in fact very dim. However, those on your world who seek these herbs for true spiritual and sacramental purposes are guided toward the right blend and purity of the herbs they are using to find a higher awareness. This happening is tied to the law of attraction, as if one wishes to use these herbs for simple amusement, they will be drawn naturally toward the dim and impure cannabis that is grown in very harsh and dense conditions. Much the other way, those who wish to use these herbs for pure purposes will naturally be met with a more pure resonance of teacher plants. This same thing can be found with many other issues and happenings on your world, and as you will soon find out, everything is related to and comes back to your natural creation powers. The dark on your world have reached a stage where they are accepting that there really isn't much they can do anymore. There is and will seem to forever be those last few holdouts who are so stubborn it evades their minds, but those souls are finding themselves increasingly isolated. With the arrests of so many of their colleagues and allies, they are realizing that this force of space people working for the light cannot be ignored. They realize and are accepting that we are neutralizing chemtrails everywhere they are spraying them, and they are now spraying chemtrails for a new reason. They are still using the same poisonous ingredients and in fact have attempted to add more poison to the mix, but now their purpose in spraying them in your skies, rather than to poison all of you, is to keep us busy while they try to create more plans and diversions. They think that they can keep all of us busy trying to clean up the mess they are daily making, and while we are busy doing that, they can sneak off and plan something. What they still don't seem to realize is just how great in number we are, and in fact the collective of us who are neutralizing chemtrails and cleaning other parts of their mess is only about 1% of the infinite amount of us who are working to bring Gaia's wonderful new age into being. You have all begun to make the changes that we are helping enact come to fruition. We have given you much help and continue to, but for the most part we can say that much of the energetic load has been taken off of us, as you all have picked up the slack. Many of you are invoking the sacred violet flame and bringing so very many loving energies in that are purifying your environments and Mother Earth as a whole, and your extremely advanced actions in doing this as a collective is bringing about the downfall of the many dark energies that have ruled for so long. It is to be expected, the downfall of the dark, as Mother Earth is now moving into a new energy, a higher energy where dark simply can't exist. It is a very natural transition when looked at from an outward perspective, but at the same time it is very wonderful to see you all freed from the darkness that has served to trap you in a mental bubble that proved difficult to get out of, but not impossible. You have all proved that nothing is impossible, as if one can incarnate on Earth, one of the densest planets in this universe, and not only come out shining, but anchor so much love and spread so much truth that you'll help transform the planet to the resonance you were residing in before coming to Earth. We think you can see that that is nothing short of spectacular. We have spoken endlessly of the need to pat yourselves on the back, and we still reinforce this point. You should take a step back and realize for humanity, and feel the joy that is associated with this. Joy is a very pure form of love, and feeling joy serves to uplift you right into the arms of your angelic guides, who will amplify your joy and send it back to you in multiples. You are seeing in manifestation many of the events we and other divine sources have spoken about in the recent past. We had reminded you some months ago of the need for you all to stand up, to take a stand for your rights as sovereign citizens of Gaia, before we would be comfortable coming down. We spoke of you taking your rights back in the form of peaceful protests, and we spoke of them specifically because we knew that was one key way the new energy was going to manifest. As we told you about the mere notion of peacefully protesting, we knew that many of you would become much more open to it in the coming months. And now, we are seeing a validation of this. Many who scribe our messages are so very happy when the prediction we give to them comes true. And we wish you to know that we are equally excited and jubilant when this happens. With all of the dates that have seemed to come and go, it is so very nice to have validation that your golden age is indeed manifesting. You are now seeing the events play out that are going to lead to our coming together as one, and we can now tell that so very many of you will be welcoming us rather than fearing us. We have figured this out through testing the waters, so to speak, when it to showing many of you our ships in your skies. We purposefully appeared before many different light workers and unawakened souls alike, and measured the responses. We used our measurements to determine when the best time would be to reveal ourselves, and what the best ways to do this would be. We can say happily that in the past few months of your time alone, our measurements have gone from low to higher and higher. We are measuring this by terms of the calm and acceptance you all experience when seeing us in your skies. Naturally, when we first started doing the tests, many of you reacted with either fear or a jolt of energy that was a mixture of excitement and deeply held fear. Those events served to show you this buried fear in yourselves, so you could root it out and learn further to accept us and our presence in your skies. Now, so very many of you see us and are very happy to do so. Even many who are unawakened are sensing the changes, the perceived newness, as when many of them see us, they too react with happiness and excitement rather than fear. The newer and more pure energies that are coming in are serving to push the hearts and minds of those unawakened toward a place of wishing for change. Therefore, when they see or sense something new and exciting, they will be prone to reacting happily and excitedly rather than with fear. This is such a wonderful thing, as it means we are now truly ready to be accepted by you all as your galactic brothers and sisters from the stars that we have always been. Greetings to all. I am Sanjay Ashka of the Pleiadian Council of Nine. I come to you all on this, a very important date in your evolution as a species. You are seeing with this date, the closing of a great cycle that has been ongoing for thousands of years of your time. Do you realize fully what this means, dear ones? You will come to realize more in the days and weeks ahead, as more is revealed both in your media and inside of yourselves. These sacred dates planned for the end of this year and for various days throughout your year 2012 will be serving to lift you all up more and more and in bigger numbers, and with the heralding of this date that marks the closing of your grandest cycle, we celebrate with boundary-breaking pure Logos energy that is coming through the newly activated energy gates and reaching you all as it serves to expand your own energy gates that you carry inside of yourselves, what you would call your chakras. Your astral body is made up of literally hundreds of chakras, but many of them are not yet activated fully until you reach higher levels of understanding and of feeling. For you see, you have to feel the expansion of your chakras and the opening of new ones, for if you don't feel, then you can't anchor the love that requires immense feeling to be able to activate and use to its full potential. You have all in fact been going through many lessons in your lives that are meant to take you a bit out of mind and a bit more into heart. Once you find a healthy balance of using mind and heart to their full advantage, you will begin to feel your other, lower chakras, and as you advance through time and space, you will feel more chakras open that will serve to bring more pure Logos energy through. You are reaching such incredible strides, as a collective and as individuals, and this is because of your master training on Earth. You have reached the finish line, the light at the end of the tunnel is embracing your spirit complexes in a wonderful reuniting, and you are once again utilizing the divine powers you have always had, but forgot for a short time. In fact, many of you will not realize that this will certainly not yet be reported in your media, but plenty of souls have in fact ascended on this date, the 10.28. As other divine sources will tell you, while this date does mark the end point of a great cycle that will see your collective evolution, the energy that has been added to it has been an effort all your own. Though you are now in the time of transition, at the shift point, this actual date or time period could have in fact meant nothing at all. You see, it is the energy you all have added to this date by its perceived significance that has made the difference, and with permission from your highest council of Gaia, we have been able to add to this energy and double it in scope and purity. As a result, many who would have instead taken the official first train home on the 11.11.11, have instead went even earlier on this significant benchmark. Some are in fact in the process right now, and many are now with us in the higher realms, serving to reactivate their true divine potential in very big ways. Many who have ascended at this time are helping us to manifest a sacred tone upon your world, a tone that will be absorbed by you all naturally, and will serve to speed up your evolution tenfold. Think about this, dear souls. Your evolution has already been sped up to that of a master curriculum, and now with the sacred tones our reignited ascended masters and archangels are assisting us to manifest, your already sped up evolution will now move even faster. This will absolutely serve to speed up the process of disclosure on your world, and not a moment too soon. Keep your heart and ears out for the sacred tone, dear souls. As you are outside, listen for the tone with the ears of your soul. Many who are still cut off from the higher realms through their own dense patterns of living will more than likely not notice this tone or will notice it very little. Nevertheless, the sacred tone will serve to work with their dense spirit complexes and speed up their evolution processes, if such is their wish. We are now stationing our motherships in countless spots around your world, as to manifest this sacred tone and perform the many other wonders we perform. We must keep ourselves in your sky for a long time. Of course, we experience the now at all times, so we do not quite perceive a sense of time going by. However, in your terms, we would say that we are in your skies almost all of the time, and as we transmute the dense energy on your world, we move closer to your surface. As your dark still tries to fiddle around and toy with us, they are soon to find that while we love them just as much as any other soul, we are not taking the game playing anymore. As mentioned above, they are attempting to distract us by spraying chemtrails all of the time, and we are to respond by beginning to do our healing work out in the open. Oh dear souls, just wait until the first time you see us openly neutralize a chemtrail. Your dark has made it abundantly clear that this is what they apparently wish to see happen. Such activities were on the last resort list, a list we thought we would not need to refer to when this whole thing began. But they have made it clear that the last holdouts do not want to give up, and we are to respond to them by showing ourselves to you all as we openly clean up the mess that the announcements will let you know they caused. We have now reached a point where we must be lovingly stern to them, as this period in your time is the period for miracles to manifest. You will see in a short matter of time, dear souls, and to keep energies high, we purposely refrain from using the dreaded soon word. Whether it is expressed in physical words or not, you are all feeling the nearness of the changes that will finally serve to lift you up out of the darkness that those who are now being detained and arrested created for you. I am Sanjay Ashka of the Pleiadian Council of Nine, and together with the Pleiadian High Council wish you to know the true strength of the Logos energy, of the energy of love. You have yet to see this energy at its more pure forms, and even we have yet to feel and experience it in its purest of forms. Our Creator and those who reside in the Creator's heavenly realms feel this energy at its purest levels, and it is an experience that even we can have trouble grasping. There is so very much for you to discover still, and we can say with absolute certainty that the time for you to know so many truths while enjoying abundance and happiness has finally come. Keep your minds and hearts focused on the immediate changes that will be happening around you, and anchor the love to dear Gaia as that will naturally serve to aid this whole expansion and transition. Thank you to the Pleiadian High Council, the Pleiadian Council of Nine and Sanjayashka.